is Janna Gajjar, Assistant Professor at ITICT Department of LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. Welcome to the second lecture of Unit 3. In previous lecture, we have discussed about a particular unit, that is a managing software project. And we have also discussed an outline that we are going to cover particular topic in this particular unit. In previous lecture, we have completed W5HH principle, that is by Barry Boehm, that is an American software engineer. And W5HH is about how, when, where, what, who, and so on. And 4 P's of that particular project management, that is people, process, product, and a project. Now, we will continue the previous lecture. Okay, so let's discuss about project management concept. So the task set for project planning. So if you are a project manager, then you have to plan according to the project requirement. Okay, so here some task sets are defined for particular project planning. So a first task is establish project scope. Okay, so in unit 4, we have already learned about a SRS, that is a software requirement specification. Okay, in which in a first chapter we are defining introduction, in which objective of that particular software, then scope of the software. Okay, so we are defining all the things. So here the first task set for project planning is also you have to establish the project scope. So what is your project scope, that is mentioned. Then second is determine feasibility. Okay, now as we already discussed in fourth unit, that once customer done with the requirement, then you have to analyze their requirement. Okay, not all the requirement by customer are feasible. Okay, by technically or non-technical. Okay, so customer always demands something new. Okay, but is there a feasible solution? Okay, so is this a feasible requirement, that will also compulsory to analyze for any project development. So you have to determine a feasibility of all the requirement. Then third is analyze task. So you are dividing project into a various task. Okay, so after dividing all the activities like modules, you have to identify that what are the risk. Okay, so if you are going to do any work, then you have to follow that what are the risk. Okay, so you have to also imagine about that. Okay, so let's take an example, like if you have your timetable for examination. Okay, so your theory time examination timetable is already declared, but if it is not declared before, then how you can plan for the particular subject. Okay, so planning is a compulsory for every project. Okay, and if it is not done, then what are the risks? Okay, so if your timetable is not properly done, then you are not able to score a good mark. So you have to also analyze a risk in your examination. Okay, so similarly here you have to identify what are the risks, okay, in your software project development. Then fourth is about define required resources. Now what are the resources that you require for software development? So it determines the required human resources. So human members, like who is going to design it, who is going to implement it, who is your QA/QC team, and who is a maintenance team. Okay, so any human person who is directly or indirectly affect your software product, that is your human resources. So you have to identify the human resources. It can be like any stakeholder, any end user, or any customer. Then you have to define a reusable software resources. Okay, so if you already have some resources, then you can reuse it. Okay, for an example, if you are developing any software in a particular language like Python, okay, so you need a Anaconda software, but if another requirement from another customer is that and the same requirement, like I need this project in a Python particular language. So you can easily reuse that particular software. So you have to define a reusable software resources in your project. Then next is identify the environmental resources. Okay, so which environmental resources you need for your software development, that you have to identify. So a fourth task is about, you have to define a required resources for your software product development. Then a fifth is about estimate cost and efforts. Okay, so now you have done with the requirement gathering and feasibility of that requirement. Okay, now you have a final requirement list. So you have to identify that what is the total cost. Okay, you have already occupied your team. Okay, that this is the team and this will going to develop this particular software. Then hardware requirement, software requirement, all things are done. Now you have to calculate overall cost for your project development. So you have to pay a salary to your team. Okay, you need any training session, so you have to pay for the training session also. Then any of the software or hardware component requirements, so you have to pay for that particular also. Okay, so here in estimation cost and effort, you are analyzing the total overall cost for any software product development. So you are decomposing the problem. Now you are dividing your problem into multiple modules. Okay, now what you are doing, you are dividing and you are defining each and every activity needs what person and what amount of resources. Okay, so you are defining resources per requirement, and now based on the requirement you will analyze the overall total cost for the particular software. So a first step is you are decomposing the project, then you are developing estimate using size, functional point, process task or any use case. So size, function point are some calculation methods for calculating the estimation cost for any software product. That we will learn in a later on lecture. So these are some methods for calculating our overall cost. So cost estimation is done and you are reconciling the estimation. Okay, now you are roughly have an idea about what is the total overall cost. Now as a project manager, you are analyzing that which kind of cost you can deduct. Okay, so you are reconciling the overall estimation. Okay, so if any of the resources or any software is already there, then you can easily remove it from a estimation cost list. Okay, so fifth step is about estimates cost and efforts. Then a sixth step is about developing a project schedule. Now you have done with all the things, but you have to schedule your project to maintain a deadline or to achieve a milestone. So you are establishing a meaningful task set. Okay, so now what are the tasks, what are the activities you need to do in your software product that you have to define? Then you have to define a task network. Okay, if any of the activities are connected with each other. Okay, so if registration is done, then and then people can log in into a particular website. So you have to define a task network. Then you use scheduling tool to develop a timeline chart. Okay, like a MS Project tool. Okay, you can use MS Project tool for defining your planning. Okay, so here 2 weeks for requirement gathering, then 3 weeks for designing, then 1 month for coding purpose, then 1 month for testing and so on. So you use any of the scheduling tool to develop a timeline chart. Timeline chart is nothing but a simple chart about your activity and time taken by that particular activity. Okay, and you have to define a schedule tracking mechanism. Okay, so how you will track all the activities that you have to define. Okay, so let's take an example of any e-commerce website. So if you are going to develop any e-commerce website for your particular shop or for particular customer requirement, then you need a project scope first. Okay, so what are the project objective and what is the scope? Then you will identify the feasibility. Okay, so what is the market need, what actually customer need, So you are analyzing all the feasibility, all the solution. Okay. Then you are analyzing risk. So if you are doing this, then what kind of risk is there? If you are not doing this, then what kind of risk is there? Okay. So that you are analyzing the risk in your e-commerce website. Then you have to define a required resources. Okay. So you need a payment gateway. Okay. For payment purpose. Then you need a designing team for GUI purpose. Then a coding team for any coding like login. You need a server side programming language. Okay. For authentication of valid user. Okay. So these are some requirements for any e-commerce website. So you have to define a required resources, a team, your software team, okay, any hardware requirement or any hardware resources that you are using. Okay, so this is about the required resources. Then you are calculating the cost. Okay, so you are estimating that if server cost is this, then domain cost is this, a payment gateway you are purchasing, then this will cost something else. Okay, so you are calculating the overall cost of that particular project. And last is develop a project schedule. Okay, so you have done with all the requirements, all the planning. Okay, now you have to schedule your planning. Okay, so you are scheduling in any of the scheduling tool. Okay, like MS Project. So you are dividing your all the tasks in a particular given milestone by the customer. Okay, so this is the task set for any project plan. Now, next is characteristics of an effective project manager. So, you all know that project manager is a very important person in any of the project development. Okay, he or she is responsible for all the things that is going to be happen in your project development. Okay, so project manager have some characteristics like problem solving. Okay, he or she is able to solve any problem. Okay, so he or she is a team leader. Okay, so if any of the team member can face any issue, he or she can definitely come to the project manager that I can face this kind of issue or this kind of problem is there. Okay, so you have a problem solving characteristic. Then managerial identity. Okay, so if you are a project manager, then you have to behave like a project manager. Okay, so it is important that you have to define you as a managerial identity. Okay, so you are a motivator for that particular team member. You have to encourage your team for particular software development. Okay, so if you are going to help your team, if you are motivating team, then it leads to the greater success in your software project. Okay, so project manager have a this kind of skill also. Then achievement. Okay, so if you are a project manager for the very first time, then you have a enough knowledge about the project. Okay, so you have also worked with any other software team. Okay, so this is your achievement. So if you have done as a lower level, then you can easily understand the problem that lower level software programmer can face. Okay, so if you are a project manager, then you have to achieve all the lower level things. Okay, then influence and team building. Okay, so if any of the team member have a conflict between them, so you as a team project or as a team manager, you have to remove that influence. Okay, and you have to build a very unique team for your project development. So you need a unique people in your team, like a high knowledge or a high skilled person. Okay, and each member have a enough knowledge about the product or project itself. So you have to team or build. Okay, so you have to construct your team as a whole team. Okay, so this is the characteristics of effective project manager. Leadership and motivation. Okay, as we already discussed, if you are a leader, then you have to take many decisions smartly. Okay, and you have to continuously motivate your team member to achieve your goal. Okay, so if they can face any of the issue, you have to help him. Okay, and if they can stuck in any of the situation, you have a alternate solution. Okay, so you have a alternate solution for particular problem. And innovation. Okay, this is the main thing that all the project manager have to follow. That if you are a project manager, then you have to always innovate all the product. Okay, so you always have an innovative idea for any software product development. Okay, so based on the market need, you have to take smart decisions. Okay, so you have to build an innovative environment for team member and also some innovation requirement for particular market needs. Okay, so these are some characteristics that is about a project manager. Okay, so project manager is able to solve any problem. He or she have a managerial identity. He can achieve anything. He or she is responsible for any of the team building. Okay, then leadership skill and motivation. Okay, and a innovation idea. So this is the characteristics. So now let's discuss about what if these all things are not done properly. So project failure. So what are the reason for software failure? Okay, if you are developing any software and you are failed to develop it, so what are the fact, what are the reason? So a very first reason is about proper understanding of customer needs. Okay, but obvious, if you can't understand the customer needs properly, then you are not able to develop a particular software. So you have to understand a customer need properly. Then second is product scope poorly defined. So if your scope of and objective of your product is not clearly mentioned, then it also leads to the project failure. Then technology changes. So here you can see that there is a trending of machine learning, data science, okay, but still you are stuck on a particular programming language like C and C++. You are not able to compete your competitors. Okay, so you have a better technology changes idea. Okay, so if you are stuck on the same technology and you are not innovating yourself, it also leads to the project failure. Then business need changes. Okay, as you all know that if I am a customer and I will give you some requirement, but a total estimate timing for developing this software is about 6 months, but within 6 months market needs change. Okay, so I have to change my requirements based on this. So if business need changes regularly, then it also leads to the project failure. So a team cannot build a project in given deadline. Next is an unrealistic deadline. Okay, so if I am not taking my deadline seriously as a project manager, then it also leads to the software failure. Okay, but obvious, if I am always extending my deadline, like if any of the team member is absent for few weeks, okay, so I will give extended time for particular team member. Okay, so it also leads to the project failure. Then team lacks appropriate skill. Customer required that I need a software in a Python programming language, but that particular team member have a Java knowledge or any other programming language knowledge. So there is a lack of skill. Okay, so if your team lack is in a skill, then it also leads to the project failure. Okay, then a managers and developer avoid best practices. Okay, so you always know that if practice is done properly, then you can easily achieve all the things. Okay, so if manager and developer avoid some particular best practices for developing any software, then it also leads to the project failure. For an example, if I already have a template for login and registration page, then I can reuse it. Okay, so it is the best decision of using a previous version. Okay, so you just need to change your color or any background effect or any template design. Okay, so this is about a reason for software failure. Okay, so you need a proper guideline for developing any software. Now what are the approaches to avoid software failure? Obviously each and everything have a pros and cons, so you can avoid a software failure by start on the right foot. Okay, so this is about if customer give you requirement, you are analyzing the requirement, then means you are feasibility study, you are doing a feasibility study, so you are analyzing all the requirements. Now based on the requirement, you are estimate the cost. Okay, and now then after, you are dividing all the project into a particular module and particular team members. Okay, so if you are going from the beginning on the right foot, then it always gives you a greater success in your software development. So you have to start on the right foot. Then maintain momentum. Okay, so you have to maintain some strategy, some methodology for particular software development. Then next is a track progress. Okay, so this is the main thing that will avoid a software failure. Okay, so as a team manager, you are dividing all the activities into particular team member. Now you have to track a record. Okay, so you have to maintain that record about what team member is doing what thing. Okay, so you need to track your progress. So what kind of things are done till today? Okay, customer give you 6 month time for developing any software. Okay, so after each and every week you have to track that what kind of activity is done and what are going on. Okay, so you have to track up progress of your software product development. Then make smart decision. Obviously, if you are a team manager or a project manager, you need to take some smart decision for developing any of the software. So if you are following all these approaches, then you can easily avoid a software failure. So this is all about the project failure and approaches to avoid software failure. So that's all for the today's lecture. What we have learned in today's lecture, we are continuing a previous topic about project management concept, in which we have learned about what are the task set for any project planning, followed by the characteristics of effective project manager, and a last, that is a project failure. So what are the reasons and what are the approaches by using you can avoid a software failure. Thank you.